We are often told that we need antioxidants, and then we're told that the only place that we can really get those, fruits and vegetables. And we are encouraged to eat several servings of fruit per day, even though fruits are not the best place to get antioxidants that are healthy for the human body. Hello, wellness warriors. Welcome to Mind Blowing Health and Wellness with Violet. The reason I make these educational videos is to help you to understand that when your mental health and physical health are working well together, that's when we really experience that overall sense of well-being. If this is something that you're working on, subscribe because I make new videos every week. Antioxidants are important because they help us to manage oxidative stress. And I was watching a video recently by Dr. Sten, and he summarized it in a way that I have not been able to summarize up until this point.
A lot of the damage in the liver is from oxidative stress. And to combat that, we need antioxidants. But it doesn't mean that we need to go and buy a bunch of supplements or products that have antioxidants. It means we need to understand sulfur and glutathione and cysteine and methionine. So what does that mean? Glutathione is the antioxidant that really matters. It's the one that the body makes itself inside the cells. And it makes it from two amino acids called cysteine and methionine that contain sulfur. So you want to try to find foods that contain a lot of sulfur, because then you get these two amino acids and you can make a ton of glutathione, which again is the only antioxidant that really matters in your body.
Because he talked about how our body goes about making are antioxidants. Like, until you understand that our body does this and it does it efficiently, and all we need to do is provide it with the building blocks to make these antioxidants, we keep falling into this idea from people trying to help us, and sometimes people trying to sell us products, tell us, which is that the only real way to get antioxidants is either through eating fruit or taking some kind of supplement. And the unfortunate side effect of believing that the only way I can really get the antioxidants I need is from eating fruit is that I end up eating fruit often, and eating fruit damages my health. Now, why am I saying that? Because if I eat fruit on a regular basis, then what I'm actually doing is having a very sweet, I don't even know what to call it, a very sweet substance that I'm having on a daily basis to try to get antioxidants, even though it's not the best source of antioxidants for the human body. Dr. Sten pointed out that first and foremost, the antioxidants that we actually need the most are the ones that are natural to our body, so the ones our bodies make. Now, uric acid and glutathione are the two that come to mind of two antioxidants that our body makes. He specifically spoke about glutathione, and he specifically said it's the most important antioxidant. I don't know if that's reality, not a doctor, but I do believe that uric acid, glutathione, and any other antioxidants that we might make, because our body makes them, then they're the ones that we should be focusing on, because they're the ones that are endogenous to us. And that just means made from our body. So even if I can eat fruit and get antioxidants from fruit, those are not the same antioxidants that my body would be making. So I want you to think about it like this. Of course, if I have a product, let's say, you know, a cell phone or a car, and it breaks, I could go and buy a generic new screen for my cell phone and put it on, and it's probably going to work 80%, right? Generic. It's not specific to the phone I have. Or I could go back to the company that made my phone and get the right model and brand and like the right for this particular phone, get the screen that goes for this one, not for the model before it, or not for a different version of the phone. And it will work perfectly because that's the screen that was made for this phone. We need to understand that when we're trying to help ourselves to heal, having any antioxidant to deal with our oxidation, or having the correct antioxidant for the human body to deal with our oxidative stress, actually it's more important to have the right one in the right scenario. Now, if I have none, then of course I'm going to put whatever screen I can get for my phone. But when we have access to the right ones, why do we choose to go with something that's not the right one. Now, for a phone, it's going to be because of price, right? If it's doing the job, then I'm not going to care that it's not specifically branded for my phone. Is that really what we want to do for our body? Well, I want you to think about this. Is it really what you want to do for your body, that you're just going to give it what could work, what's possibly going to work, that it's similar, so it's close enough? Or are you going for the specific antioxidant that your body would have made anyway? And the only way to get that is to give your body the building blocks to make it anyways. And this is where Dr. Sten helped me, because Dr. Ekberg actually talked about what do you need to actually help your body to produce the antioxidants, so glutathione in this case, that it wants to produce. So here we go. In actuality, what you need is cysteine, methionine, and sulfur. Those seem to be the three key ingredients that are, so our body cannot produce those three things on their own. If I eat things with cysteine, methionine, or sulfur in them, then my body will be able to produce glutathione. And so now the question becomes, how difficult is it for Violet to eat things with cysteine, methionine, and sulfur in it? Well, you're going to be surprised to learn that it's absolutely easy to do. And best of all, I can do it without eating carbohydrates. So therefore, I don't need to eat fruit. High levels of cysteine can be found in meat, eggs, fish, cheese, yogurt, and sunflower seeds. High levels of methionine can be found in meat, eggs, and fish. Some seeds like sesame seeds, Brazil nuts, and some other plant seeds. And then, of course, there's the overlap that you can find sulfur in meat, fish, nuts, and seeds. What are we learning by looking at this information? I didn't say fruit or any vegetable, because our body can make glutathione without us eating any fruit or vegetable. And since, according to Dr. Ekberg, now again, not a doctor, I can't dispute this with him, he said this, it's the most important one, the most important antioxidant. So if it actually is, and we can make it ourselves, why do we chase eating fruit and cause damage to our bodies unnecessarily? Because we don't know better. And honestly, I feel like that is actually the answer. Doctors have been telling us for years, the government has had it on their website for years, that the nutrition guideline says that we should eat 4 to 6 servings of fruit per day, fruit and vegetables. And we've been doing that because they taste good. But is it actually the healthiest thing for us to be doing? And I believe after looking at Dr. Ekberg's video, I understand it's not the healthiest thing for us to do. As a matter of fact, it goes towards what I was saying a few weeks ago, a few months ago, and ever since I've learned this information about what was causing my hip problem, all these sugary foods that we've been led to believe are healthy and as healthy as whole foods from animals are not. Led to believe that fruit is as healthy as low glycemic vegetables, they're not. And even the low glycemic vegetables are there for our entertainment. They're not necessary for us to eat. If I know that, then am I making a better choice? Am I eating for my health and wellness? Am I choosing foods that give me the building blocks and the reparative building blocks? So this is for reparative nature. Being able to produce glutathione means that my body can manage my oxidative stress, because every time I eat and all the processes that my body does do produce waste. And then my body needs to be able to clean up and do with the processes what it needs to do so that I can stay healthy. Are you giving your body the best possibility to help you to stay healthy? Think about this, wellness warriors, because this could be the difference between you feeling amazing and you feeling eh. Are you gonna buy the secondhand or off-brand screen for your phone? Or are you gonna put the name brand? When it comes to your body, I'm encouraging you to choose name brand. Put in yourself what's supposed to be there. There's some videos on the screen right here that are going to help you to improve your health. I want to thank you for watching Mind Blowing Health and Wellness with Violet. I really can't wait to talk to you guys again next week.